procedure is pretty simple. Here is the parking brake, so you can release the parking brake first. So just pull the handle up and then turn it to off position. And turn it to off. Just turn the wheel. Yes, all the way off. So you feel this aircraft start to move. And here are the throttles of the aircraft. The aircraft has two engines, left and right engines. So we can throttle both engines together to the second dip and here, flex and MCT. So you can push both throttle forward to the second click. So you can push forward, and this is the first click, yes. Yes. So the aircraft will start moving and the engine will screw up. And you can put your left hand on the side stick. And as the aircraft accelerates, you can see here on the left side is the speed tape of the aircraft. It's now 80 and 90 knots. So when the aircraft says V1, that's the safety speed for takeoff. Says V1 and then I'll say rotate, you can start pull back slowly on the stick.
V1.
So rotate, pull back slowly on the stick. Yeah. Hold it there, yes. And then the aircraft starts to take off. And you can release the stick from it now. Great. So as now you can see, here is a pre-cross at the middle of your instrument. So your target is to try to put the pre-cross here at the middle of the black dot. So here the pre-cross is just a little bit up of your instrument. You can just pull a little bit up. That's correct. Until the pre-cross is right at the middle of the black dot. So you can now push forward a little bit. Yes, until it's right at the middle of the dot. So after we have airborne, the landing gear can be retracted. You can use the right hand here to pull up the landing gear. To pull the landing gear up. That's correct. And then the landing gear will retract. And now we have completed the takeoff roll procedure. You can see the green cross is below your black dot. So you can push forward a little bit on the stick until the green cross is right in the middle of the green cross. That's correct. That's correct. You can also see on the top left corner, there's some letters flashing. That means that you can now reduce the engine to a climb setting. You can pull the throttle back to climb defense, to click backwards. And climb here, the first click. Yes, that's correct. And you can also follow the green cross to put the nose down a little bit, push forward. Yes, that's correct. Airport. Of course, in reality, it is already a cruise terminal. happy at your post in the Flight Simulator. We love that airport, so we keep it there as it's in 1997. Have you ever visited the old airport before?
Yes.
It's in Kowloon City, and I used to live there, so I used to watch the aircraft landing right there when I was small. So we will now do some basic maneuvers like turning and climbing. So say now we are heading towards the east, but say the air traffic controls for whatever reason want us to turn towards the north. So we can input a heading of north by 360 to here, the heading up, and then you see the green cross starts to go to the left already. Until the green cross is right at the middle of the red dot. That's correct. So as the aircraft banks, and the aircraft will turn towards the north side. Time Ocean. It's just right next to the approach area of Hong Kong, and that's why this is considered to be a little bit dangerous approach.
That means you're now 2,000 feet above the ground, and the land, the airport.
aircraft is pretty simple. When you are approaching the runway and then you start to hear your altitude decreasing, like 500, 400, 300, and then when you hear 50, 40, 30, when you hear 30, 30, you can close the transmitter, idle the engine, and then let the aircraft settle on the runway smoothly. And that's it, pretty simple.
That's your phone, right? So I should stop recording first.